The conventions are now officially over. Thank God. Aren't you relieved? There were a lot of lies spewed. And Vice President Kamala Harris delivered her big speech last night. I thought it was the best she could do. She delivered a nice speech that obviously somebody else wrote for her. And that's one of my other questions. Who wrote it? Because it certainly seems like Team Obama. What about David Axelrod and the Pod Save America guys? Are you actually writing her speeches and advising her and then going on air and talking about how amazingly she performed? Because that's not okay. John Meacham, we're not united. We're not going to be united. Her boss said that too. And then within a year or two, we got Dark Brandon. Kamala Harris absolutely crushed this. Presidential as any convention speech I've ever heard. Ben Rhodes, former Deputy National Security Advisor under Obama. Kamala just did some real work on foreign policy, combating autocracy, supporting allies, standing up to Putin, speaking to the suffering of Palestinians in a way that we rarely hear. This is someone ready to be president right now. Here's another one for you. Jonathan Chait, New York Magazine. Best acceptance speech I've ever seen. He goes on to say it was perfect. Absolutely perfect. You know, the joy, 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 joy. I mean, it's everywhere. It's so annoying.
Happy, happy, joy, joy. Happy, happy, joy.
It's obviously all a campaign to excuse away her bizarre cackle.
After a nearly flawless convention in Chicago, Democrats are riding high. The energy and excitement at a level we haven't seen since Barack Obama first won the party's nomination nearly two decades ago. For Kamala Harris, that has translated into hundreds of millions of dollars in campaign donations, a flood of volunteers, and a boost in the polls. As Donald Trump watches his lead evaporate, both nationally and in the key battleground states, Politico reports he is, quote, finally recognizing he's at risk of losing the election unless he makes some changes. Trump has been trying to portray Kamala Harris as a left-wing radical. But so far, anyway, that hasn't stuck.
They're failed, weak, and dangerously liberal.
A cheetah will defend his feast from other predators at all cost. Cheetos, dangerously cheesy.
The Democratic Party has become so radical under Kamala Harris that a member of the Kennedy family has come out to endorse a Republican.
I don't know if Bobby Kennedy Jr. at this point is that representative of the Kennedy family, but I want to get to that in a second.
Well, President Trump and his campaign has known all along, and they've said all along, that this race is going to be a close race.
Actually, he said it would be a landslide, just to be clear.
She said when she ran for president that she wants to eliminate private health insurance on the job for 170 million Americans.
That is not her position now. She knows.
How do you know that's not her position? How do you know that's not her position?
I mean, she says she no longer
she has not
supports
said that. She has not
Medicare
said that.
For all.
She has not said that.
No and then.
And then.
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 No, no and then.
And then.
Maybe you're gonna start to piss me off, lady.
And then.
And then? I'm gonna come in there and I'm gonna put my foot in your ass if you say and then again!
Kamala Harris is a dangerous San Francisco liberal.
RFK Jr. endorsing Donald Trump on Friday. What Donald Trump said about RFK not that long ago, just weeks ago, he said of RFK Jr., don't waste any Republican or conservative votes on Jr. He is one of the most liberal lunatics ever to run for office, a phony radical left fool. So now all of a sudden I've respected the guy forever. I love the guy. What is going on?
No longer believe that I have a realistic past.
RFK Jr. is out. He endorses Trump and joined him on the campaign trail.
So all of a sudden here, there's a big question over whether or not the vice president and the former president will be debating in 2 weeks.
Now it appears that Trump is raising some questions about this. He posted on Truth Social that he had some concerns about ABC and whether there was some bias there, in essence. The polls are trending in Harris's direction. There's no question about that. And we may see a further bounce as a result of the Chicago convention.
So there's a shark 10 yards away from the boat. 10 yards or here. Do I get electrocuted if the boat is sinking, water goes over the battery, the boat is sinking? Do I stay on top of the boat and get electrocuted? Or do I jump over by the shark and not get electrocuted? Because I will tell you, he didn't know the answer. He said, you know, nobody's ever asked me that question. I said, I think it's a good question. I think there's a lot of electric current coming through that water. But you know what I'd do if there was a shark? or you get electrocuted. I'll take electrocution every single time. I'm not getting near the shark. I'm not a big fan of sharks either. I have people calling me up, sir, we want to do, we have a fund to save the shark. It's called Save the Shark. I say, no, thank you.
Special counsel Jack Smith has filed an appeal in former President Donald Trump's classified documents case out of Florida. He is urging the 11th District Court of Appeals to reverse Judge Aileen Cannon's decision to dismiss the case last month. Smith argues his appointment to the case was legal and that proceedings should restart as soon as possible.
All right, some news just into us right now, where the special counsel Jack Smith has returned what they're calling a superseding indictment against Donald Trump in that D.C. case.
You know, a lot of people are like, well, Trump is a bad person and he gonna get his. You know, some people never get theirs. Some people just fail up. You know, people are like, well, you know, what goes around comes around. No, it don't. Sometimes it just keeps going around. Ain't nothing gonna happen to Trump, man.
I think ABC is a disgrace. I think ABC is really should be shut out. I'd much rather do it on NBC. I'd much rather do it on CBS, frankly. I think CBS is very unfair, but the best of the group. And certainly I'd do it on Fox. I'd even do it on CNN. I thought CNN treated us very fairly the last time.
Trump is slamming the network hosting the September event, even hinting in a Truth Social post that he may drop out.
More than 200 Republicans who worked for both former President Bush's Senator John McCain and Senator Mitt Romney have endorsed Vice President Kamala Harris for president. The group penned a letter saying in part, democracy would be, quote, irreparably jeopardized by another Trump administration.
Some of them did the same letter for President Biden's campaign in 2020, about 150 former Republican presidential administration staffers signed a similar letter saying that electing Trump is untenable. You're seeing 200 this time.
The Trump campaign is facing backlash for an apparent altercation at Arlington National Cemetery between the Trump team and cemetery staff. According to NPR, while there, Trump campaign staff verbally abused and pushed a cemetery official when the official tried to prevent the Trump campaign from filming in Section 60, which is a section of the cemetery reserved for those recently killed in America's wars abroad. Arlington National Cemetery confirmed the incident. The Trump campaign says an unnamed individual did block members of Trump's team, but denies a physical altercation occurred, and they claim to have video to back up their account. However, they have not released that video.
NPR reports a cemetery staffer tried to stop Trump's campaign team from entering a section where recent casualties are buried. In return, the campaign staff got verbally abusive and pushed him aside. NPR says Trump's campaign team denies that and says they've got the video to back up their side of the story. But as of now, they have not released it.
I know we have some reporters here. If you would, let's start with the local reporters. We'll have them ask some questions, then we'll kick it over to some national folks.
Could you tell us more about the altercation that happened at the Arlington Cemetery?
The altercation at Arlington Cemetery is the media creating a story where I really don't think that there is one. There is verifiable evidence. There is verifiable evidence that the campaign was allowed to have a photographer there. There's verifiable, they were invited to have a photographer there. There's verifiable evidence that the families of these poor people who had their loved ones die 3 years ago at Abbey Road, they had, excuse me, Abbey Gate, those 13 Americans, a lot of them were there with the president. They invited him to be there and to support them. That's not an insult to the memories of their loved ones. They wanted Donald Trump there, and thank God that we have a president who stands with our veterans instead of one who runs away from them. Now we...
As commander-in-chief, President Trump always had his soldiers and their families' backs, and always will. Harris and Biden failed our soldiers and their families. President Trump never will.
Donald Trump's back, and he's out for control.
I would have every right to go after them.
Complete control, and he has a plan. It's called Project 2025, a 922-page blueprint to make Donald Trump the most powerful president ever. He'll take control, we'll pay the price.
I'm Kamala Harris, and I approve this message.
I'm doing a new series of Trump digital trading cards. You purchase 15 or more of my Trump digital trading cards, and we'll mail you a beautiful physical trading card. Each physical trading card has an authentic piece of my suit. Purchase 75 of my Trump digital trading cards, and you will also be invited to join me for a gala dinner at my beautiful country club in Jupiter, Florida. I'm keeping my Trump digital trading cards at the same price of $99 each.
Hand me down the shark repellent bat spray.